I think we're going to have church here today. And you know, one of the things, you know, I like about that, it says when he's shut up in my bones, he's like a fire. And you know, I ain't a very smart man, as old Forrest Gump said, but I know one thing. I know one thing. When you got a fire, you got something hot. And if you got any feelings at all, when you touch something hot, you just got to let it go. I said, you just got to let it go because you can't hold on to it. It's too hot to handle, they say, amen, too hot to handle. The word, amen, the word, the truth. Does anybody know what I'm talking about? The word, the truth. Do you know who the truth is? Do you know what truth is? It's Jesus. Jesus. And when you got a hold of the truth, you got a hold of some fire that needs to be let loose in this world today. Oh, come on, let me hear you, church. Amen. Jesus in your heart, you got to let him out. He's just like a fire. You got to let it go. Matter of fact, when he's walking here on this earth, he wanted the world to know who he was. And he still today wants the world to know who he is and what he's about. Boy, I tell you what, he came to the world to save the lost. And praise God, that was you and I. Although some may not claim they're lost, but they're as lost can be. But amen, when you come to the senses and realize you're lost and undone without Jesus, amen, then you can have, amen, the free gift of love and mercy and grace bestowed upon you by the fire of truth, amen. If you confess your sin, he's faithful and just to forgive you of your sins and give you, amen, eternal life. Woo! Praise God. I tell you what, there are some folks, amen, wish I was dead and gone. Oh, yeah. And you know, there's some that I wish that old bald-headed man would just kill over. But I got news for him. I'm just not going to kill over. I'm going to live forever. Yeah, I'm going to live forever. Why? Because Jesus has given me eternal life. Eternal life. A life, amen, that lasts forever. And boy, I tell you what, if you don't believe me, just ask the blind man. He saw it all. Ask the blind man. He saw it all. So if you got your Bibles, turn with me over into the Gospel of Mark in chapter 10. We'll be looking at verses 46 through 52 here. 46 through 52. Are y'all with me this morning? And they came to Jericho. And as he went out of Jericho with his disciples, a great number of people, blind Bartimaeus, the son of Timaeus, sat by the highway side begging. And notice we got Jesus, amen, in Jericho. He's passing through with his disciples. They were heading toward Jerusalem. This will be the last time that Jesus would pass through Jericho. I want you to get that, but it's the last time he'll pass through Jericho. There's a beggar by the wayside, by the roadside. He's begging for alms. He couldn't work because of his sight. He needed dependence upon people to help supply his daily needs. The Bible said he was begging. And when he heard that it was Jesus of Nazareth, he began to cry out and say, Jesus, thou son of David, have mercy. Notice he said, have mercy. Have mercy on me. Is anybody here was a beggar that you couldn't see? Maybe not physically, but spiritually. And you was begging, amen. Begging for direction in life, begging, amen, for a better life. You've tried the world and everything the world had to offer, amen, it just turned sour. But you heard about Jesus, who is able to make the blind to see and the lame to walk. You heard about Jesus of Nazareth, amen. You heard about the son of David. And you cried out just like blind Bartimaeus here. Jesus, 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 have mercy on me. And many charged him that he should hold his peace. How many people told you, don't cry out to Jesus? Just shut up, man. You don't need him. All you need is another fix. All you need is another drink. All you need is another this or that and the other. You don't need him. Be quiet. Be quiet. You don't need him. Oh, but that didn't stop him. He cried out the louder. Amen. Boy, we need to cry out, amen, when the world tells us to shut up. Don't tell others about Jesus. We need to just cry out that much louder. Amen. Jesus is our only hope. Oh, let me say it again. Jesus is our only hope. Without him, there is no hope. There is no future. There is no life. But he cried out the more a great deal, Thou Son of David, have mercy on me. And Jesus stood still and commanded him to be called. And they called the blind man, saying unto him, Be of good comfort. He calleth for you. He calleth for thee. And he, casting away his garment, rose and came to Jesus. And Jesus answered and said unto him, What wilt thou that I should do unto thee? Listen to what blind Bartimaeus said. The blind man said unto him, Lord, that I might receive my sight. And Jesus said unto him, Go thy way. And I want you to notice in the next verse, he says, thou faith hath made thee whole. And immediately he received his sight and he followed, amen, Jesus in the way. He followed Jesus in the way. Once again, this was Jesus' last time to pass through Jericho. Jesus, along with his entourage, was heading to Jerusalem to celebrate Passover and there later to be crucified for mankind's sin. Everyone this day had crowded around the divine teacher to hear what this holy rabbi had to say. Jesus will pass by one day your way for the very last time. The last time Jesus was to pass through Jericho, he sees and hears a blind man calling out, Thou Son of David, have mercy on me. Oh, blind Bartimaeus may be blind physically, but boy, he could see clearly spiritually because he was crying out to the right one, wasn't he, for help. He was crying out for the right one for help. And tell me, amen, nothing is a coincidence. Everything is divine plan and control. God had him in the right place at the right time for the right purpose. Woo! Glory to God. God got you right here today. Right here, this time. You didn't come here by accident. You came here because God sent you here. Oh, you're in the right place at the right time for the right purpose. And God wants you to get something from this message today, or something from the song, or something, amen, to encourage one another and to uplift one another. He is here, amen, and he's got you here for that very purpose. Oh, blind man, Bartimaeus, he was calling on the right person here, amen, that could provide what he needed in life. He received that divine miracle. We saw that in the last portion. He received his sight and started to follow Jesus. He cried out for help because he needed help. If Jesus was to pass by your way the last time, and I'm just a country preacher, so I'm going to just say it country, all right? Would you have sense enough to call out to him? Would you have enough
common sense to call out to the one who could help you. If he was to pass by your way for the very last time, and this could be your very last time, because we're not guaranteed that we'll see the sunset. So he's passing by. So with, amen, your spiritual eyes, would you see what blind Bartimaeus saw? He saw that Jesus Christ was the Son of the living God. Matter of fact, he believed this was God in the flesh, as John said. It was God himself walking amongst the people. Blind Bartimaeus could see who Jesus really was. Do you know who Jesus really is? Do you know that he is the only way, the truth, and the life? And the only way to heaven is through him? Do you know that he is the door of heaven? Do you know he is the life giver and the life taker? Do you really know that he's the one who created this universe? Do you know that he created you? Do you know him? Blind Bartimaeus knew who Jesus was. He knew who Jesus was. He wasn't blinded spiritually. He just had a physical impairment. Amen? Disparagement. I'll get it right in a minute. Amen. You know, sometimes you're preaching, you catch yourself saying words. Yeah, you need to get a dictionary, you know? Yeah. He had a vision. He had a physical, but his spiritual eyes was wide open. But the problem with some of us, amen, we see physically, but our spiritual eyes are blinded to who Jesus really is. Blind Bartimaeus could see who Jesus really was. When he cried out, "Jesus, have mercy on me. Have mercy on me." He was declaring his faith in Jesus Christ and who he was. Blind Bartimaeus, amen, knew who Jesus was, and he knew that Jesus, second of all, was his only chance. Only chance to see physically. This was the last time Jesus was to pass through Jericho. This was the last opportunity, amen, he had. Matter of fact, it wasn't the last, it was the only opportunity. You know also it's possible to send away your day of grace. It's possible to harden your heart as in the day of provocation. And it could be your last opportunity to accept him. Last opportunity to receive the gift of salvation he's offering you. Blind Bartimaeus wasn't going to risk, amen, his last chance. His only chance. Blind Bartimaeus not only saw who Jesus was and knew that it was his only chance, but third of all, amen, blind Bartimaeus could see that the crowd was wrong about who Jesus was. Friend, today, can you see that the world is wrong about who Jesus is? He is the absolute truth. And if you want to know what moral, amen, obligations are, start reading his word and he'll lay it out for you, amen, because he is the way, the truth, and the life. And you got to do it by the book or you ain't going to heaven. Amen. You ain't going to heaven. I know there's preachers out there in the survey who said that there are preachers preaching that you can go to heaven by being a good person. You can be good all your life. But the Bible says there's none good, no, not one. That's truth. And we all stand in the need of salvation, no matter how good we are. We stand in the need of God. Amen. We stand in the need of forgiveness. We stand in the need of mercy. Amen. And praise God, blind Bartimaeus knew the crowd was wrong. And they cried out, amen, "Shut up, man, shut up." No. I know this is my only chance. I know who he is. And if I'm going to get something from him, it's got to be today. Jesus, have mercy on me. The crowd was wrong. He could see that. And number four, amen, blind Bartimaeus could see. Hey, they can call me whatever they want to. You can call me a fool. But praise God, he could see. Amen. With his eyes that the world was wrong, and even though he might be a fool for Christ, he knew where his bread was buttered. Amen. I like that, amen. Woo! Yeah. He made a decision to become a fool for Christ. He just cried out that loud. Are you a fool for Christ? People might look at me and say, you off your rocker. That's all right. I know which way I'm rocking. Amen. Yeah. Some say, you a holy roller. That's all right. I'm holy and rolling on the Jordan. Amen. Yeah. You can call me what you want to, but when he calls me, you can call me gone. Amen. Oh, blind Barnabas. Amen. You can call me whatever you want to, but I'm going to cry out because I know what he can do. Call me a fool. Blind Barnabas could see there was no turning back. Once he decided to follow Jesus and cry out to him for mercy, he knew there was no turning back. Amen. Because Jesus had a better life for him. Jesus, amen, got a better plan for your life than you'll ever have. I know the plans I have for you, said the Lord. Jeremiah 29:11. I know the plan. A plan, amen, to prosper you, not to do you harm. And boy, old blind Bartimaeus, amen, he said, it's got to be a better life than sitting by this wayside begging every day. Oh, Lord, that I might receive my sight. Old blind Bartimaeus could see the obvious when Christ asked Barnabas, what is it that you would have me to do? He said, Lord, that I might receive my sight. That I might receive my sight. If every man and woman could realize that today, that I might receive my sight. Because every man and every woman without Christ is blinded. Few blind souls ever see their need for Christ. Why is it that a lost man does not see his obvious need for Christ as blind Bartimaeus did? Because Satan got him blinded. Thinking that the world has something better. The world only has destruction. It entices you until you take the bait that is artificial. Anybody like artificial stuff? Y'all, you do, you like the real thing. Y'all remember a commercial that said, nothing like the real thing? It's nothing like the real thing. Artificial bait. How many fish use artificial bait? The fish goes after that because he thinks it's something good for him. He thinks it's something real and that it will satisfy his hunger. Right? And you put it on a hook, you entice it. It's just like the devil with you and I. He puts it out there, makes it look like the real thing, the thing that is going to be beneficial to you, only to hook you. And when he hooks you, what does he do? Reels you in. And if he's a hungry devil, he's going to devour you and destroy you. Just like a fisherman does that fish when he's hungry, amen? Cleans him out after he catches him, devours him, takes his life from him, and devours him, amen? Consumes him. We can be blind and we can get caught. But Jesus said today, before you jump and before you leap on that artificial, I got something real for you. You want the real thing that will satisfy the hunger and life you're looking for? Do you want the real thing? That you can have life and not be devoured or consumed? Do you want the real thing? Then come. I noticed what Jesus said to blind Bartimaeus. He says, thou faith. That indicates to me that blind Bartimaeus had faith in who Jesus was before Jesus even arrived there. Thou faith has made thee whole. Thou faith has given you sight. And see, without faith, the Bible said it's impossible to please God. But we must come by faith to Him. Believing in His Word. Trusting in Him. And if the Bible says we need faith to come to Jesus Christ, then by God, let's have faith. that Jesus said, if I confess my sin, he's faithful and just to forgive me. I believe that. Amen? And that's by faith. Of faith, according to what he said he would do. And by faith, I walk with Jesus every day from that point on. Why? Because, amen, the Bible said faith will produce works and works will produce faith as well. And they both worked hand in hand. He says, show me your faith and I'll show you works. Show me your works, I'll show you my faith. And faith in God and following him. The Bible said that blind Bartimaeus had faith in God. And he was there on this day for a purpose for the crowd to see. If you only had faith, you can see who Jesus really is. Who Jesus really is and what Jesus was really going to do, not only for them of that day, but for you and I who are sitting here today. Oh, that I might see. Oh, he didn't say that for him. He said that for the crowd that I might see. Oh, have mercy on me that I might see, that I might receive my sight. Everything changed that day that Christ passed by. Barnabas, amen, blind Bartimaeus, knew that in order for Christ to fulfill Bible prophecy, he would have to heal blind eyes. He had blind eyes, and he could help Christ accomplish the purpose for which he had came into this world. Do you want to help Jesus today? I can't hear you, Lord. Give me hearing, because I can't hear nobody. Do you want to help Jesus today fulfill his purpose? Amen. Do you want to help Jesus fulfill the purpose, the reason he came? That purpose is still going on. He ain't sound the trumpet yet. Amen. We're still here, right? We still got to follow. And we still got to share what that purpose is, that man might receive his sight. Faith comes by hearing, and hearing by what? The Word of God. The Word of God. Today, God is looking to seek and to save that which is lost. You and I are to share that message, who know him as our Lord and Savior, and who have received our sight just like blind Bartimaeus. But maybe you're here, you're spiritually blinded, and you're not fulfilling that purpose as of yet. Then, friend, I encourage you today, come to Jesus. It may be your last opportunity. It may be your last opportunity, so don't take it for granted. Today, open your hearts to him and say, Lord, have mercy on me. Have mercy on me. And open the eyes of my heart, Lord, that I might see you. I might see you. You are my reason for living. And you're my purpose for life. Every head bowed and every eye closed. No one looked around. Friend, I want to ask you today, if you need prayer, you'd like for me to pray for you, would you just uplift your hands and pray for me, preacher? Thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you, thank you. Amen. You can put them right back down. Amen. Thank you so much. Maybe you're here today and you don't know Jesus Christ. I'm not embarrassed. He'll not come to you. Would you just say, pray for me, preacher? I don't know him, but I like to. Would you pray for me? Is that one? Father God, as we come to you today, Lord, I thank you for these hands that went up. Thank you, God, for them. Lord, I ask God, whatever the need is in their lives today, you meet that need, Father. And Father, everyone in the sound of my voice are here for that purpose, Lord, for you to meet a need that they may have. Father, I pray, God, you'll meet that need today. Father, I pray, God, that you'll just look down upon each and every heart here. And whatever need, Lord, meet that need as they come to you today, Father, just as blind Bartimaeus did. He cried out to you. Father, we are fixing to cry out to you in our prayers as we gather around this altar today. Father, meet us there. friend, God has spoken to your heart. You have the prayer. You have that need. You come. You